What is the worst Tinder date that you've ever been on?
So I went on this date 2 years ago in Boston. This girl, hitting it off, having a great time. So I'm paying for the check, and we're going to the movies after. So all of a sudden, this guy sits down at the table with us, and she's pale as a ghost. So I went to the guy, I'm like, hey, man, can I help you? She's like, oh, that's my wife. I said, well, what? Wife? And he goes, yeah. I says, I look at her, and I go, is that your husband? So she's like, I'm just trying to make some excuse. Best part of all, sees something around the corner of my eye. It's her daughter. She jumped on her lap. Mommy. And I was like, I looked at her, I'm like, how long have you guys been married for? 7 years. 7 years. So she lied that she was married. Married for 7 years and had a kid. So I'm just sitting there at the restaurant like, wow, this is like a Dr. Phil episode. So he's sitting over there. She's sitting over there. I'm in the middle. I said, guys, this is like Dr. Phil, the Maury Show. You got to figure it out. So she jumped up, ran out. So he was crying, he had his head on the table. So I got my money, put it in the check, gave it to the waitress, and saw the whole thing. She was in awe. She looked like she just watched the season finale of The Bachelorette. That's another story another day. So I looked at his daughter, and I said, excuse me, sweetheart. I was like, you ever see Pets United? And she said, no, I want to see it. So I tapped him on the shoulder. I said, hey, man, I was like, I've never been in this situation. I said, we should get out of here. I was like, we'll just go to the movies. And you try to get your mind off of it. So he agreed. I mean, he paid for the movies, candy, and all that. So I got his number. We stayed in touch. I want to make sure he's all right and everything. Didn't know him from a hole in a while. It's just how I am. He eventually finalized for divorce, moved out. We stayed in touch. A year later, I bumped into him out at the bar. And I was up with some friends. I introduced him to a friend of mine. She's a sweetheart from Boston. Sweet girl. They were hitting off at the bar.
According to divorce.lovetoknow.com, and you guys can go look this information and data up for yourself, approximately 13% of married women admitted to cheating on their husband. Now, notice I said admitted, because most women don't like to accept accountability for anything. They love to hide things. They're very sneaky and calculated when it comes to cheating. As opposed to men, we just do it because, hey, we want to smash, you want to get a nut off, and, you know, now it's back to dealing with the missus and the family. Women, they do it for a lot of different reasons. For emotional reasons, they want to feel a different vibe. They're tired of being a wife. They're tired of being a stay-at-home mom. You know, they don't want to deal with the husband right now. So they just want something different. They need a different emotional connection. Women do way more emotional cheating than actual physical cheating. So they might not have sex with you, but they'll go on a date with you like she did that guy in the video. Here's the crazy thing about women being on Tinder and married women on dating apps. There's a lot of them on there. And if you guys have done the dating apps and different things, you can say that, man, there's a lot of married women who are trying to hook up, who like my profile, who match with me. And it seems like married women are actually the easiest to have sex with. Reason being is they're cooped up at home. They got their beta provider. They got their husband. They got that white picket fence living in the suburbs. And they got that 2.5 garage, that dog and kid and everything. And now they got that security. Now they want to go out there and have fun, because they probably got some single friends, or, you know, they're on social media looking at all these different women having fun. And now they're like, you know, I already have my husband. I got the provider. Now I want some real fun. And this is what a lot of women do on dating apps. I've been on Tinder, and I'm quite sure you guys can attest to this as well. Married women liking your profile, talking about, oh, my husband doesn't mind. You know, we're just going through some things, you know, and it's like, to me, it's kind of off, because you never know how that husband is going to react. He could be like, you know, hey, what are you doing with my wife? What's going on? He could walk in. Who knows? He could have blew that guy's brains out at the restaurant, right? There's instances that stuff happens where a husband, you know, blows the brains out and kills the wife, takes the kid's life, and then turns the gun on himself, right? Because he's invested so much time, so much money, energy, all these emotions, different things into his wife. And he thought his wife was going to love him to death, do his part, and uphold those vows. But she did anything but that. Now he's like, man, I have to take action into my own hands, because he's put his entire identity into his wife, into his family. And now that he got crossed by his wife, he's like, man, what am I going to do? I don't even know taking care of my wife. I don't even know giving her a life, right? He basically put his entire life on hold, his dreams and ambitions, to probably work for a little company that he doesn't really like. But hey, he's like, hey, this gets the bills paid and it keeps my wife happy. It keeps a roof over my family's head. This is why I was never a fan of hooking up and having sex with married women. I've had many offers, especially on dating apps. Because married women, they get bored really easy. I mean, let's be honest. It's easy to hook up with them because they've been dealing with one guy and now they want a different experience. They want a different vibe. They want a different connection, right? Women are go off energy. So if they have something consistent, now they're like, okay, you know, I need to switch it up. I need something different. Even they could have a perfect life. The husband could be a great man, could work for a Fortune 500 company, but she'll go off and cheat and hook up and hang out with a dude who's nowhere near the status and income as her husband. See, what a lot of guys don't want to tell you who are married is that their wives really don't like them like that after so long. Because deep down, their wives are kind of missing being out there in the field. You know, testing the water, seeing what's out there. Their female friends are probably single. And they're like, man, you know, what is it really like? And then the wife starts to kind of get angry at the husband and start fights and do different things. And in his mind, he's wondering, what's going on? Baby, I'm doing everything right. Let me get you some flowers. Let me do this. Let's go on a trip. And all in her mind, she's like, okay, I'll accept it. But man, I just can't tell my husband, my spouse, that I want another pipe. I want to get smashed by another guy. This is how it is when it comes to marriage. So aside from your money being taken, the house being taken, you being a weekend dad, the dog being taken, and half your business being split. And listen, alimony and child support, disloyalty doesn't get talked about enough when it comes to marriage. Because a lot of women like to cheat. A lot of women, you know, they secure that guy and they're like, okay, man, I'm ready to get back out here. I'm ready to see how it is. I want to relive my glory days, right? But a lot of the times they end up regretting it because they end up hooking up with a guy, they divorce, and now she can't get that same situation going again. She can't get that happy wife, happy life. So when a lot of women cheat, especially married women, they're doing it from a place of loneliness, right? They want some connection. They want something else going on. This is why, guys, if you're dealing with a woman and you think about marrying her or you think about settling down with her, look at her friends. Look at her lifestyle. Ask about her history. That is important. Don't allow anybody to tell you that, oh, her history is nothing. That means nothing. No, the things that she's done in the past is vital because she's most likely going to do that in the future. So she's cheated on dudes, she slept around, she did this and that. What do you think she's going to do to you? There's an extremely high chance she's going to repeat the same things that she's done in the past in the future. This is why you need to properly vet women. And you need to know, hey, is this the type of woman that's been promiscuous or who's, you know, who likes different guys and everything like that? Now, everybody's attracted to other people. Even if I'm in a relationship, even if you're in a relationship, you still look at other women. But it's the fact that you acting on it. And a lot of women, they have these fantasies. It starts up here. And they think about the guy that, oh man, that guy's cute. He's at the store. He's attractive. And they just wondering and wondering and wondering. And then they step over that edge of that cliff. And boom. Now they realize that, man, I'm dealing with this guy. I got a husband. I got a spouse at home. I got a boyfriend. And what do I do? Right? And they just hook it up with that guy and they start to feel some sort of, they feel bad, but they don't feel that bad because in their mind, they're like, you know, I've done the wife thing. I've done the mom, the stay-at-home mom, and I've done all that. So now I just want to see, you know, what else is out there. I don't want to miss out. And it's that fear of missing out that a lot of wives start to cheat on their husband. Because most, you know, studies, they say, oh, you know, wives, they don't cheat that much. You know, it's usually the man. Right? And men do some cheating here and there. Yeah, let's be honest. But we're not as covert as women. Women like to hide and conceal and say, oh, you know, and they're going to the girls' night out or their the wine day and all these different things. And they're going to the book club. And then all it takes is to them to hook up with a guy, meet a guy, boom, just like that. See, it's far easier for women to actually cheat because all it takes them to just hop on a dating app. They get tons of matches. Tons of messages. Even if they're a married woman, dude's like, I don't care. But it comes to married men, oftentimes, more often than not, you get on a dating app and women kind of shy away from him because he's married, right? So when it comes to women cheating, they have loads of different avenues, different options. They got dating apps. They got social media platforms. They got guys at work. They got guys at the drive-thru, the Starbucks, the gas station. Everywhere they go, especially if she's an average to above average looking woman, she's going to get hit on regardless. So the temptation is actually there, right? And especially if she doesn't have much going on in her life, now she's going to look for a new quote-unquote adventure. As opposed to the husband, he's out there grinding, building a life for his wife, his family, and he thinks he's doing everything right. But then the wife has a different agenda.